Does this look familiar? Hi everyone, it's Francis with a brand new tutorial for Shotgrid. If you want to be notified when new videos come up, be sure to click the subscribe button at the bottom right corner, or you can follow me on Instagram at soyouwannabeprod for daily tips and tricks and notification when a new video is up. Alright, so today I'm going to be sharing 5 productivity tricks that I use on a daily basis in Shotgrid. Make sure to watch all 5 for a bonus tip at the end. Trick number 1. Stopping Shotgrid from refreshing when filtering for multiple variables. Every time that I click a different filter, Shotgrid will stall for a couple of seconds. For example, I want to see the characters and props only, and for shot 10, 20, 30, 70, and 90. Now watch the center screen every time I click on a filter. I'm going to click on character, and you see that pause, and then I want the prop, it paused again. 10, 20, 30. So it's not too bad, but sometimes it stalls too much and it could get annoying. So to stop that from happening, I'm gonna clear my filters, is to hold control and then click on the different filters. I'm gonna hold control, click on prop, character, and you'll also notice that it's not refreshing the screen left over here. That means that Shotgrid is not yet filtering the variables that I'm setting it to, because I'm holding control, so I'm controlling it, so to speak. And now I'm going to release control, and then you saw that spinning circle for a second, so that's when Shotgrid started thinking and filtered my list. So hold control as you click the filters to stop it from refreshing. Trick number 2 is to save page as your own. For example, now that I've set up a page with the filters that I like, I don't want to have to do this every single time. So I'm going to save off a page that already has my settings and my preferred filters saved automatically. To do that, I'm going to click on the top right corner and click Save Page As. I'm going to give it a name, so I'm going to put my initials and then asset, let's say list. And then if your pipeline allows you to create new folders, I'm gonna create one for my own, so FP for my initials, and I'm gonna create page. Once I click create page, watch what happens to the page name on the top left corner. Currently this page is called assets. I said I'm gonna rename it as FP asset list. So I'm gonna create page. And it changed the name on this from assets to what I renamed it to, meaning this is no longer the global page that I was looking at before. This is now my personal page, which means I could customize it to my preference without affecting the pages that are meant for everyone else who's using the same Shotgrid instance. Trick number 3 is to favorite a page. Once you favorite a page, it will appear as a button under the project pages, my pages, and under your favorites. So that means it's very quick for me to click on my asset list if it was here. But to favorite a page, you're gonna go to the top left corner and click on the star. It'll get grayed out. So now if I go to project pages, I'm gonna go to my pages under favorites, and now you can see that I have my asset list page. If I'm currently in the shots page, I could easily just go to project pages, my pages, and go to the asset list. Trick number 4 is how to revert a page to its original setting. There will come a time where you're on a page and you're adding or removing columns, adding fields, changing your filters, and you'd be changing the default page to something unrecognizable. To revert it back to its original setting, you can go to the top right corner, click on the drop down, and click on Revert Page. And it should bring it back to its original form. I do have one caveat that sometimes, depending on your pipeline or your studio, you might not have the permissions to change the pages themselves. If that's the case, then the revert page might be permanently grayed out for you because you're not able to change the page in the first place. And last but not least is the undo button. So there is an undo button in Shotgrid, and it appears as a blue box at the top. If you're doing one thing at a time, it's it's pretty easy to just replace whatever you just entered. But if I'm assigning multiple things, for example, it's be a lot quicker to undo in bulk. Let's say I want to assign the modeling task for 4 assets. So I'm gonna assign this to artist number 2. And click on save. So again, the moment I click save, a blue box should appear at the top here, and click on save. Boom. So this will appear indicating like, hey, you have updated the assigned to on 4 task, which is consistent to what I just did. And I made a mistake. Actually, I don't need that to be artist number 2. You can click on undo. And those 4 will disappear. Alternatively, while I have 4 of those tasks selected, I could right click on one, edit assign to, overwrite it. We're going to assign it to artist number 3 and click on save. And as promised, a bonus tip. Whenever you make any changes to a page, a blue button called modified appears in the top right corner of that page, which is pretty handy when it's hard to tell if you've made any changes to the page at all or you're resetting it before changing a global page. And again, if I want to revert this to its original setting, I could click on the top right corner, revert page, and it should return it to its default. Thanks so much for watching. If you found this helpful or think it could be helpful for someone else, please consider to like, comment, and share. It really helps to spread the word. And I'll see you next Sunday. Bye!